to lie, so true. So mom, she's pregnant right now, and I don't think in my life I would have ever told anybody to abort pregnancy. Of that thing, right? I don't know. How do I explain this thing? Do you not swim?
No.
I'm trying to look for something. Do you? Is there anything that you were scared of before, and when you did it, you weren't scared of it no more? I'm trying to think of something like that. Yeah. Talk. Do you have something like that?
Wait, let me think.
Okay.
Well, I think Wait, que se comienza ese parque de atracciones en inglés? Wait, in
what language is that? What language is that? What language is that?
It's Spanish. I'm trying to say.
I love it. Yeah.
Getting ugly, still I look for the beauty. Girls selling the coochie for the Gucci. All I see is good girls trying to show love. Same time, all these groupies acting bougie. I came in the game like, yo, excuse me. Shout out my OGs and shout out my juvies. Get robbed for your carty with a little Uzi. Brothers shooting clips like an action movie. And I know it seems stupid, but brothers ain't seen no love, they need Cupid. Even though we're winning, we're still sinning. And this ain't gonna change overnight, it's deep rooted. Flashbacks of dead bodies and gunshots. Last time I see my brother's face was a mugshot. PTSD will leave permanent scars.
I've been focusing too much on YouTube. It's time to make some TikToks. Light on, ring light, chair, power, pure bliss and fresh air to enjoy myself. What else do I need? Okay, I need to plug this in. Okay, I need to turn this on. Baba Mishishe. Mama Washiku. Oh,
that I eat that pussy. Yeah, don't stop it, bro. I'm drinking my favorite. God knows they catch me points about it. Allahumma laka sumtu wa ala rizqika aftarta.
To you is our best defender this season, Mingeza or Alba? So.
Sorry, I was typing the message at first, but it was too long and I got tired of typing. So I decided to send the voice message, but it was interrupted and I was accompanied to the message. But basically what I wanted to ask, last year before the lockdown, Last year, my elder brother dropped out of university. He dropped out of school. We don't really have that type of relationship whereby he does something wrong and then I say, okay, Daniel, this stuff you did is
wrong. Why do you think what he did was wrong?
And like vice versa, he's like, you can't tell me. I don't know how to place it in context, but we don't really share that type of relationship whereby I can tell him, okay, this.
So Faith, first off, thank you so much for opening up to me about this. So why do you think that him dropping out was wrong? You know how messed up Nigeria is, right? If you have a degree, you are wasted. So if you do not have a degree, your life might even be wasted so much more because like you can't even get a basic job, right? So I feel you, but then why do you think him dropping out was wrong? What me I would say is if he fully believes in his music to the point where he fully believes in it, he should drop out and try it out. I mean, if he believes in his sound, from what I heard you just said right now, that means I don't think he believes in his sound. And even if his sister does not believe in his sound, that says a lot about his music. But I mean, there are so many people that have blown, and even though their immediate family did not believe in them, I feel you. But then I know what you're saying, like you're coming from the fact that you're his sister and you really want the best for him, and you know that there is no reason for him to drop out when he can't continue school and still do music. And even when the music has now happened, then he can now drop out. But if the music has not popped, why will he drop out, right? But you said something about him doing drugs, right? Yeah, that one is totally flat out wrong. You cannot be sure about it. And something I've noticed about human beings is if they want to do something, they'll do something no matter what you tell him, right? No matter what you say to him, he will still do drugs if he wants to do drugs, right? So yeah, you can touch on that. Like, you can just be like, bro, at the future you only run drugs, and no wala, I know you will still do what you want to do, but then I really think you should try to stop it, because the moment you start doing drugs, it's not something that is easy to stop. You can just tell him that part. Now about the dropping out, I think if he believes in his sound, let him drop out. Let him. He will face the consequences. He will either blow or he will not blow. If he blows, it will be good for everybody. You said you're going to enjoy him. If he doesn't blow, he will figure his life out, right? But then if there is a way he can go back to school, he should go back to school. He should continue. Like the way Nigerian system is right now, the way the internet is right now, you can be in school and still be running your music, right? Even with school, so it's easier to run your music, because like you can tell your classmates to jam your stuff, you can tell your classmates to push out your stuff, right? I mean, he should just go to school, even though he's failing classes. He should just go to school and at least have the degree, right? He should just try not to carry over, right? He should just at least get 50 over 100. I don't know. But one thing I'll tell him, that dropping out, as badass as it sounds, and many people are doing it nowadays, if you do not have a solid plan, it is not a very good idea to drop out, for me, right? But let me tell you something, no matter what you tell him, he will still do what he wants to do. So just do your part as a sister by telling him, and... say yes, because she understands kind of thing you're going through right now.
Then you talk to her, mommy, see, I don't want the baby. I don't want to keep the baby. You tell her reasons why. You give her four reasons. One, there is no father. I don't know if I'm ready for that. Two, I'm not ready for pregnancy. I got 9 months. Mommy, I need to go to school with my friends, everything. Three, you also tell her that, what's that thing? Three, you tell her that you don't think you're even ready to give birth. You don't think you're ready to go to labor pain. You don't think you're ready to be a mother. Blah, blah, blah. She should understand. I think she would understand. And I know no mother would want a child to abort and she doesn't know what she's doing. And actually, all of these things still feel. I feel like I want her to just call me right now and tell me that she came up with everything that she's been lying. But I don't think it's a lie. It's so true. So, but she's pregnant right now. And I don't think in my life I would have ever told anybody to abort pregnancy. But then I think my advice to her this time is to abort. Because she actually said she was going to commit suicide if she found out she was pregnant. I told her not to commit suicide. I told her that the better thing she did is to abort, right? My three goals for this week will be one, I want to strengthen my relationship with God, because this is Ramadan, right? And I'm supposed to get very close to God. And normally what I do, normally when I was younger, right, in Ramadan when we're fasting, I finish my Quran twice in a month. What do I mean by that? The first 20 days I'll read Quran, and I'll finish the whole thing, right? And last 10 days we used to do itikaf, right? Itikaf is where we leave our house, we go to a mosque in Ikoyi. And for that last 10 days, we'll live there. And because of the vibe, because of the environment, it was very easy for me to finish the Quran every time in Ramadan. Right, because of Corona, we can't do itikaf this year. We couldn't do it last year too, right? So, I might not have the opportunity of itikaf this year to get that vibe. What I'm saying is, even as I'm in my uncle's house here, like, we're the only Muslims here fasting, I have not been reading my Quran. I've just been, because there's TV, there's Netflix, there's Wi-Fi, there's YouTube, and nobody's disturbing me. I'm just playing around, but I want to commit to reading, to trying to finish my Quran. And I think I have like 15 more days in Ramadan, so let's see how it goes, right? So I'll update you guys in the vlog. That's one goal I want to achieve. Another goal I want to achieve is I eventually got people to work for me and my team, right? Like, I put out a video on Instagram asking people down to work with me on this journey of trying to help people, inspire people, create my legacy, and like, let's see how we can create meaning and impact in the world. And yeah, a couple people messaged me. I have picked the people I want to put them in slots, but I've not fully incorporated them to the point where we can automatically start working. So that's one thing I want to achieve this week too. What's the third thing, Seth? Don't forget. So that's two goals. The third goal will be, and you guys have to see the progress. That's the point of this vlog. I'll mention the goal and I'll show you guys the progress. That's the whole point of this. And I wish for every one of you that is watching of this vlog, every Sunday or Monday, anytime you're starting your week, set three macro goals. That's three big goals that you want to try to achieve in that week. Then every single day when you're waking in the morning, set a mini goal, right? So like for me now, since this is for the week, so for today, what I'll try to do is, one, I cannot finish the whole Quran, but I'll try to read like 10 chapters in a day. I'll try to achieve that. Two, for the team thing, and I cannot automatically automate everything together. I'll just tell myself, I want to automate Josh. Josh is one of my team. And I want to automate Faith. I just want to get them to start working on my Instagram reels and my IGTV, something like that. So I'm talking too much. I love you guys, and let's see how this journey goes. Bye bye. I just had a wonderful meditation until. Now I have to be the one to do the DM, right? Like, some people asked that they wanted to do that on the team. I said no, that it has to be me that will send the DMs, right? So that's a lot of work, because it's not easy. I'll send the message on DM, send email, blah blah blah. But what I'm saying is, out of 50 people are going to send DMs, right, at least one person will respond. And if one person responds, I will get to do a podcast with them every week. So I'm going to get guests. Yeah. Yes, yes.
Hello? Hello, Faith. Can you hear? Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Okay, that's, yeah, that's fine. So, what? Obviously, yeah. So, now I'm saying, I'll message bad guys like that. I feel like if I interview them, like it makes sense. So, if one of them responds, I'll do a podcast with them that week. But the next week, I wouldn't deal with a big guy. The next week, I'll deal with an upcoming person. What do I mean? Someone like me, right? Like, maybe someone like you, anybody, right? But then, I'm looking for people that they have big dreams. What's it called again, see? Hello? Yeah, can you hear me?
I can't hear you, but the line is breaking.
It's breaking. Wow.
Yeah.
But can you hear me now?
Yes, I'm hearing you now.
So when I put out the stuff about the team, before like you started talking with me, right? Like before I even sent you like what you want to do and blah blah blah. What was the thing in your own head that you thought you wanted to contribute to the team? Like when you heard Mo wants to create a team, what did you think you would contribute? Like I want to know what you originally wanted to contribute. You feel me?
Swear I won't forget this, why do I regret this? In my mind reckless, thoughts are feeling endless. Sitting up, I'm breathless, anxiety's infectious. I feel so defenseless, betrayed and embarrassed. I hate being open, I hate being broken. I feel like an ocean filled up with emotion. Anger ain't a potion, rub it on like lotion. I can feel it soaking, reopen, the scars have awoken. I can't move on till I let go. I feel so lost, never at home. Need to be strong.
Don't worry, I'll try to help you work with that. If you can send me like a snapshot of the things you've written in your book, like, don't worry, that's part of the things I want to do on the team. Like, all of you that, like, you're not the first person I'm having this call with, right? Like, I've had this call too with other people on the team, and I truly want to help you guys achieve your goals too in some way possible, because of you guys are going to help me too in some way possible. So both the confidence and negativity, we'll try to see how we can work towards that. So yeah, is there anything else you want to say before I start talking about
Hello, what's up?
Yeah, good afternoon, how are you? Yeah, can you hear me?
I suck mommy's own job. I'm saying so much of it.